today's date was with Courtney.
Well, I was definitely looking forward to bringing Courtney back. I had a really good time. I know she was a little bit more guarded the first date, but me and her have kept in contact since then. I just really enjoy keeping in contact and the connection we feel through keeping in contact. So, yeah, I mean, I was very excited to have her come back for this date.
Did I think about if I was going to be date number two or if there was going to be a date number two? I did, actually. I feel like everyone asked me after they knew, you know, the insiders, friends and family that knew I was doing it. And I kind of had a feeling I'd be on date number two. So, yeah. So for the date today, we went to the Culver City Steps. And we went, so it was a little hike, and it was actually really cool. It was really pretty. It was windy, but we had fun. We laughed a lot, kind of joked around, pushed each other.
We're gonna enjoy a nice little friendly competition to see who can get up there first.
Obviously,
no! These guys running are gonna beat us, but.
Oh my gosh! Okay, I'm not super competitive.
Yeah, just watch out. I do cheat. I do push.
What?
I bite. I pull hair, and I throw into bushes. So. Just be prepared, okay?
Okay, I don't like this.
Okay. Are you ready to do this?
Yeah.
Let's go.
And at the top, we had a little picnic set up. Oh my gosh, it was so cute, melted my heart. He totally surprised me with like lunch all set up nice and cute and, you know, fake champagne. That's always appropriate on these type of dates. And it was just really cute. The view was awesome. It was good company. I really enjoy talking to Chris. He's really easy to talk to. I'm a goofball, so I think we just kind of vibed off that and joked around. I feel so bad sometimes because I give him such a hard time, but he's a champ. He takes it. So.
Went up the Culver City Steps, and at the top, when we got to the top, we had a nice little picnic sitting up there, and we had a little sparkling cider, and we were trying to wonder how to open it because it wasn't a twist top and we didn't have a can opener. So I, being an Eagle Scout, just me being a little resourceful, I had my knife on me, my Stripling Warrior knife on me, and I just kind of pried it open a little bit. But I also, before that, I started using my teeth because that's how I'll open bottles sometimes when they're not twist tops. I'll use my teeth. I have really hard teeth, so I'll use my canines and I'll just dig in and get it out. And not too many people were too happy about that. Like, don't do it, Chris. No. So I gave up and I just was like, all right, give me the knife. I'll pop this open. And it wasn't a twist top. It was definitely a true bottle top.
The view was awesome. I mean, it was cute and romantic, of course. But it was really pretty. It was cool. You could look all the way around, you know, see the ocean from the city of Los Angeles. And I've never really, I mean, I live in Arizona now, so you don't really go up anywhere high to see the city, really. And so to be able to see that was really cool.
Well, after we finished the picnic, we started hiking down. The bag broke that we were carrying our stuff in. It was kind of funny. We ended up having to hold it together and bring it all the way down together because it was a pretty heavy bag. but after that, we hopped in my car. I gave her the present that we had for her. And I made her guess what our next activity was going to be. And within the bag that I had for her, there was nail polish, an air freshener, and some like nail stickers. And she was like, And right from the get-go, she knew. She was like, "You were getting a pedicure." I was like, "Yes, we are," which is not my style because, you know, I'm not the type of guy that usually goes and gets a pedicure. This is my first one ever, and I'm 26 years old, so.
Of course, I'm like, oh my gosh, we're getting a pedicure, which is awesome because I freaking love pedicures, and Chris has never had one, so I took his pedicure virginity. But it was way fun because just seeing like his face and like understand why girls love this was awesome. He was giggling. Oh my gosh, it was almost embarrassing because he was super ticklish. But I was too, but I can hold it in a lot better than he can. But we had a good conversation when we were sitting there and relaxing, and it was super cute and thoughtful for him to do something like that. That's not something a lot of guys would think about to do. So that was cute.
Yeah, she has the qualities that I feel like I could easily get in a relationship with, but it's just about the time. It's about the time spent, not just on the camera, but off the camera as well, because I mean, I mean, we've talked about this. You're a little different in front of the camera, and that's okay. That's to be expected. But the time that I spend off the camera is the time that I really get to know these girls a little bit better. And I'll make my decision off of those and the time that we spend on the camera, so.
For being a Mormon, I would definitely say I'm a little more edgy. I'm open to, I think, everyone, and I've tried to be that my entire life and just not be judgmental. And, you know, I've had very different experiences than I would say a lot of Mormons. And, but yeah, I mean, I could go with the edgy Mormon type. It's been fun. I've had an interesting, crazy life, but I've enjoyed it. And I like, you know, I've learned a lot, and I think it's definitely pushed me to be better, if anything else.
I don't need people to compete over me. It's just about who's good for me. It really is. You know, I'm a little picky, and that's okay. You have to be picky when you're dating somebody. It's about finding who is good for you. It's not about, oh, this person's good enough, this person's good enough. It's about being good for each other, not anything else, not trying to meet expectations, because if you're just yourself around the person, you'll know, and you'll be good for that person, and they'll know if they're good for you. So.
Did I notice anything physical? I think we like have that physical flirtiness, like we touch each other, we'll get close to each other, we'll do those things, and so I've definitely noticed that it's different this time than last time, because I'm so reserved normally, like on dates. I mean, I think more physically, like I get, you know, nervous just to like put myself completely out there. And I think this time we were a lot more comfortable and like, you know, being okay with touching each other appropriately, of course.
Do I feel like Courtney's high maintenance or low maintenance or sedentary? No, like right in the middle. I think she likes looking pretty and gets up and likes dressing up and getting that way. I mean, she's gorgeous. She's an absolutely beautiful girl. And I would be completely lying if I wasn't physically attracted to her, because I am. She's gorgeous. She's got a great smile, beautiful eyes, and she really can go out and rough it. She can go out and goof off, go out on these little hikes. She still looks good doing it, and she doesn't care exactly how she looks. She just had a fun time. When the wind was blowing and her hair was getting tossed, she just had a big smile on her face, and it just felt really natural to be around her because of that.
Where do I feel now compared to before our second date? I feel way more comfortable around Chris. I think, you know, the first date is always, you don't know what you can and can't say, kind of feeling out their personality as well as they are to you. But I feel comfortable. I mean, I can basically say anything to him, and that's a really good feeling to have. So I like where we're at right now.
Yeah, I think me and Courtney are definitely in similar spots in our lives. I mean, she's just started her career probably about a year ago, and I'm about to be done with school and on to my career and on to another set of schooling for me. And I think we're kind of in like a verge where we're both realizing that marriage is something that we want right now. Marriage is something that is super important, needs to be our goal right now and our focus. And it's just about whether me and her decide if we're good for each other. So that's what it's all about. It's about the mutual respect that people share when they're in a relationship with each other.
From what I know so far, do I see a serious relationship? I think there's potential there. I really do. And I think we're both kind of open to it. And I know he is probably, like, to the relationship. I mean, that's what he's doing this for and all. But I mean, if things progress, I definitely could see something happening.